位观众大家好，现在是4月23日晚上19点整，斯德哥尔摩文化之夜已经进行一个小时了。刚才我们教大家做饭，现在我们欣赏节目，由中欧文化协会和北欧绿色邮报网联合举办的北欧之春和平文化节文艺演出部分现在正式开始了。本次活动得到了中国驻瑞典大使馆和欧盟东北同乡会、瑞典沈阳同乡会等多家社会团体的积极支持，在此我代表主办单位向他们表示衷心的感谢。Hello everyone, now it's 19 o'clock and April 23rd, 2022.Stockholm Kulturnatt is underway. Here is a China Culture Night, jointly held by China Europe Culture Association and the Green Post. We got support from Chinese Embassy in Sweden, EU Northeastern Town Fellow Chamber of Commerce, and Shenyang Town Fellow Association in Sweden. We have taught youhow to make Chinese food just now, and hope you have already had a good dinner. And now let's enjoy the beautiful program of culture and music. 现在让我们欢迎中国驻瑞典大使馆张彪参赞致辞。First, let's welcome 张彪, counselor at the Chinese Embassy in Sweden, give his congratulations remarks.Welcome.
女士们、先生们、朋友们，大家晚上好。非常高兴在斯德哥尔摩文化之夜参加中欧文化协会和北欧绿色邮报组织的北欧之春和平文化节。文明多样性和文化多元性是人类社会的基本特征。文化交流有着纽带和桥梁作用，能够增进不同国家和人民之间的相互了解和彼此信任，有助于世界的和平稳定和繁荣进步。上世纪50年代，中瑞两国超越意识形态和社会制度差异，建立了外交关系。瑞典成为第一个与新中国建交的西方国家。70多年来，两国关系不断发展，务实合作成果丰硕，人民友谊不断升华，成为中西方国家友好交往和互利合作的典范。国之交在于民相亲，民相亲在于心相知。面对当前人类社会前所未有的挑战，为推动中瑞两国关系更好更长远发展，我们更需要加强文化交流，增进相互了解，开展互学互鉴，凝聚发展共识，通过友好协商深化友谊合作。长期以来，在瑞华侨华人积极融入瑞典社会，努力传播中国文化，在中瑞之间架起了一座友好交流桥梁，对瑞典民众客观认识中国，特别是当代中国，发挥了积极作用。今天晚上的活动就是一个生动的实例，不仅是华侨华人展现自身风采，促进瑞多元文化发展的一场重要活动，也是一次宣建中国文化、增进中瑞友谊的实际行动。希望瑞华侨华人和侨社侨团今后更多展示自身风采，发出自身声音，为中瑞关系发展做出更多贡献。最后，祝文化节圆满成功，祝中瑞友谊长存。
感谢张参的热情洋溢的讲话，感谢使馆对我们的大力支持。Thank you, Councillor Zhang, for your encouraging remarks. He said that civilization and cultural diversity is the basic characteristics of our society. Culture exchange functioning as a joint and bridge can promote mutual understanding and trust between different countries and peoples. It is conducive to world peace, stability, and prosperity. In 1950, China and Sweden surpassed ideological and systematic differences, and Sweden became the first Western country which established diplomatic relations with China. Over the past 70 more years, bilateral cooperation are deepened and fruitful. Bilateral friendship has been deepened, and such development served as a good example in relations between China and Western countries. It is important for the two peoples to feel closer to each other, to feel good with each other, and understand each other very well. Facing unprecedented challenges and pushing forward Sino-Swedish relations, we need further strengthen culture exchange and improve mutual understanding. We should learn from each other, try to form consensus and deepen friendship and cooperation through friendly negotiation. Chinese in Sweden have long been actively integrated in the Swedish society and functioned as a bridge between the two countries. This is conducive to the objective view of Swedish on Chinese. Tonight's event is a good example for the Chinese in Sweden to express themselves through culture forms and promote culture diversity. It is a real practice in improving Sino-Swedish friendship. Hope you are going to have more such kind of activities to express your voices and contribute further to Sino-Swedish friendly relations. May Sino-Swedish friendly relations last forever. 感谢张参的热情洋溢的讲话，感谢使馆对我们的大力支持。现在我简单介绍一下中俄文化协会在过去两年的工作。2019年，我们举办了“一带一路”北欧之春国际和平文化节，举办了文艺演出和中国画展。画家李丽的中国山水画和新疆图片展。2020年疫情开始，感谢中国驻瑞典大使馆的大力支持，给我们口罩，我们也给大家邮寄了口罩，有一部分会员也通过华住中心获得了口罩。2021年我们进行了网上女儿情舞蹈培训，还在6月20日进行了表演，但是由于疫情原因，大家没有聚会。Now I'd like to brief you about our past year's work. In 2019, we held the Belt and Road Nordic Spring International Peace and Culture Festival. We held an art exhibition of Chinese artist Li Li and other artists. We also held a Xinjiang photo exhibition. 2020, at the beginning of COVID-19, we got support from the Chinese embassy and many Chinese organizations they give us masks. Thank you all for your help. 2021, we held online dance lessons learning from the web video and held a performance on June 20th, 2021 with Xinjiang photo exhibition. I believe this summer we might find a chance to meet, likely on Zoom. We shall use Zoom more for communication and enjoy culture activities. We shall continue to have culture and art performances, art and photo exhibitions, and exercise Tai Chi and dance. We hope peace will resume soon in the world, and more culture exchange will be done. Stockholm Kulturnatt is exactly such a good example of culture communication for peace and development. It contributes to our psychological health, and it is very important in Sweden. 我相信我们从今年开始可以慢慢地恢复正常，即使不能正常聚会，我们也会慢慢地习惯 Zoom 聚会，让大家可以身心健康，共同享受中华文化，让音乐舞蹈抚慰我们的心灵。明年我们将继续搞文艺演出、绘画展和图片展，做更多中瑞文化交流方面的工作。例如，我们可以继续邀请李丽会长教大家画画，我们可以继续练习太极和舞蹈。 当今世界并不太平，因此今天的和平文化节更显得有意义。我们要继续维护世界和平，通过文化交流消除误解，通过文化交流增加彼此的信任，希望俄乌冲突，俄乌双方化干戈为玉帛。斯德哥尔摩文化之夜对我们的精神健康非常有好处，非常重要。下面请大家欣赏精彩的演出。第一个节目是女声合唱《鸿雁》，这是一首蒙古族歌曲，通过鸿雁的迁徙反映海外游子思念家乡的情怀。表演单位：瑞典华人爱乐合唱团，指挥杨小音。Now let's enjoy a chorus, Swan Geese, by Chinese music loving choir in Sweden, Commander Yang Xiaoyin. The song is about swan geese, but reflects people's nostalgic feelings.谢谢，下面请欣赏大提琴演奏巴赫的 Minuet No. 3，表演者赵晶晶。Cello, Bach's Minuet No. 3 by 赵晶晶。 钢琴演奏献给爱丽丝片段，表演者陈安妮 Piano for Alice 安妮 Axelsson。下面欣赏小提琴《花儿为什么这样红》，表演者伦德涵 Field Why is the flower so red? By 伦德涵 This is a song from Xinjiang. Thank you. 下面请欣赏古琴演奏《黄鹤楼》，宋·孟浩然之《广陵》，演奏者Xuefei，古琴 by Xuefei。I'm sorry to say that I don't play very well, but thanks to Cecilia Lindquist, a sinologist in Sweden, who has promoted Qin and wrote a book about the Qin, and also Deng Hong, Cecilia Lindquist's teacher's daughter, also a master in the Wu Qin, and she has taught us for three times over the past years, and I have learned from her. So this is just to show my exercise in Gu Qin. And the Qin is a 3,000 year history, 7-string instrument. So that is a very profound Chinese culture. And the melody is about the friendship. Next, 葫芦丝，军港之夜，表演者王玉书。Bamboo instrument, 葫芦丝。The night in the port, by 王玉书。
自己的河州，京港之夜。
Now let's enjoy 扬琴《难忘初恋情人》，表演者荣根 ，Unforgettable First Love， 荣根 playing 扬琴。Now let's enjoy the singing. 渴望春天，演唱陈雨桐。小鸟，小鸟，演唱陈嘉欣。梨花又开放，演唱者周一鸣，指挥杨小音。So three students sing beautiful songs.About the spring, the birds, and the trees and flowers.
Lai ba, 亲爱的五月，给树林换上绿装，让我们在小河旁看紫罗兰开放。我们是多么愿意憧憬那紫罗兰，来吧亲爱的五月，让我们去遥望。冬天也曾给我们带来了许多欢喜，在雪地上，在稻下，大家欢聚一起，用纸牌打起小屋，还做个庄游戏，在自由可爱的大地上上雪橇旅行去。当小鸟唱起歌，报告春天也来临，在草地上跳舞是一番欢喜。来吧可爱的五月，快带来紫罗兰，也多多带来布谷鸟和绿的夜雨。
Thank you. 香，年年梨花放，染白了山岗，我的小村庄。妈妈坐在梨树下，纺车嗡嗡响。我爬上梨树枝，闻那梨花香。摇摇洁白的树枝，白玉满天飞扬，落在妈妈头上，掉在纺车上。给我幸福的故乡，永生难忘，永生永世我不能忘。花又开放，找到了我的梦，我一腔衷肠。小村一切都依然，树下空荡荡，开满梨花的树下，纺车不再响。摇摇洁白的树枝，白玉满天飞扬，两滚滚泪水流在树下。给我血肉的故乡，永生难忘，永生永世我不能忘。摇摇洁白的树枝，白玉满天飞扬，落在妈妈头上，掉在纺车上。给我幸福的故乡，永生难忘，永生永世我不能忘。摇摇洁白的树枝，白玉满天飞扬，两滚滚泪水流在树下。给我血肉的故乡，永生难忘，永生永世我不能忘。我不能永忘，永不能忘。
Now let's enjoy 答案在风中飘荡，是诺贝尔文学奖得主鲍勃迪伦的歌曲。他是不支持战争，希望和平，希望人们吸取教训的啊。Blowing in the Wind, composed by Bob Dylan and re-sing by Xuefei。
答案在风中飘荡，一个人要走多少路才能称得上男子汉？一只白鸽要飞越多少片海才能安歇在沙滩上？炮弹要飞多少次才能将其永远禁止？朋友，答案在风中飘荡。一座山峰要屹立多久才能回归到大海？那些人还要生存多少年才能最终获得自由？ 一个人可以回首多少次，只是假装他没有看到。朋友，答案在风中飘荡。答案在风中飘荡。一个人要仰望多少次才能看见蓝天？一个人要倾听多少次才能听到人们的呼喊？要牺牲多少条生命，他才知道太多的人已经死亡？朋友，答案在风中飘荡。答案在风中飘荡。
Next, Liu Qian and Su Zixian 合唱《大风吹》The Wind Blows Heavily by Liu Qian and Su Zixian. And now let's enjoy The Spring Comes to Xiangjiang River by flautist Crystal Wu Jing. Wu Jing 演奏《春到湘江》。
Thank you.
女声独唱《阳光路上》，表演者杨小音 ，solo The Sunshine on the Road by 杨小音。下面请欣赏舞蹈《敦煌》，表演者孙元，《敦煌 Dance》by 孙元。
Thank you.
下面请欣赏瑜伽表演，李新瑞、苏梦涵 Yoga by 李新瑞 and 苏梦涵。Now let's enjoy Peking Opera, The Buddha by 郝景霞，京剧选段，观音得道。
Thank you. 天龙八部护身符，佛在心头坐，三万八千五两佛，那我
一次演出呢，如果没有这个脱口秀或者是东北小品啊，就是觉得有点美中不足哈。那么今天呢，我就试着给大家讲一段脱口秀，叫我的家乡和我的祖国 talk show， I my hometown and my motherland。 大家好，我是Xuefei啊，今天我给大家说一段脱口秀。我本来也不会说脱口秀，但是我受到李雪琴和李诞的鼓舞，在2020年那个春季特别郁闷的时候，朋友给我发一段视频，原来啊是李雪琴的脱口秀。他说李雪琴长得像我，我仔细一看，哎，确实哎，李雪琴长得贼像我年轻的时候。我那时候啊，就是脸部吧，比其他同学宽一点啊，眼皮儿也比别人宽一些，厚一些，嘴唇儿也比较厚一些啊，说话就是东北的大碴子味儿哈。先说我自己吧，疫情一开始可把我给吓坏了，我还真不知道原来我是个胆小鬼啊。我这个跟我女儿说，我说你别上学了啊，你没事儿啊，你，但是如果你染上了。你把我和你爸都感染了怎么办呢？他说，妈，你不用担心，即使你染上了你也死不了，因为你不是那个 Nico Group， 就是说啊，你才50多岁，你不属于那危险人群。哎，从那以后啊，嘿，我还真坚强了不少啊，不养儿不知父母心哈。再说我的家乡啊，那口音也是东南西北中啊都不太一样的。比如大连丹东一带的，他们就说你们啊，他不说你们，他说俺们啊，我还以为他说的是俺们啊，俺们是我们的意思啊。比如说俺们是本溪人哈、啊、沈阳人呢，他就是我们，他不说我们，他说咱们。啊，咱们家啊，那感觉就是咱们都是一家人啊。然后再说我家那个锦州啊，锦州呢，它就是特殊疑问句儿啊。有一次我从沈阳回锦州，一小伙见着我了，大姐，听你口音不像本地人呢，啊，听你口音不像本地人呢，啊，问话的时候也特别高哈。啊，你问铁北电影院呢，那远着呢。嗯，后来在校园里头，我看一个同学说话，哎呦，把我们吓一跳呢。Are you a student 咋的呀？最后呢，我再想给大家介绍一下中国啊。中国的特点呢，就是西高东低。那么从歌曲的曲调就能体现出来啊。比如说这个西藏啊，那就特别高啊。要不然我也表演一下哈哈，摇篮索，哎呀，那就是青藏高。 那往东一点的山西哈，我家住在黄土高坡啊，这就也比较高啊。再往东一点哈，内蒙古大草原，哎，它就比较平缓一些，像汩汩的流水哈，还是这样哈。跟我的心去趟草原吧，那里有会唱歌的河水，也有成群散步的牛羊，也是我梦中的家乡。然后再往东哈，你看这个黄梅戏哈，就比较平缓啊，也特别平缓啊。树上的鸟儿成双对，露水青山带笑颜。再往东呢，就更平了哈，你像这个福建呢，海峡，台湾海峡的这个鼓浪屿啊，鼓浪屿四周海茫茫，海水是我家乡。你问我爱你有多深，我爱你有几分？我的情也真，我的爱也真，月亮代表我的心。谢谢大家，我是雪飞。最后，让我们欣赏男声独唱《我和我的祖国》，表演者旅欧著名男中音歌唱家刘克清。刘克清老师呢是在德国，居住在德国，请欣赏 I and My Motherland by 刘克清。
各位朋友大家好，我是中国旅欧男中音刘克清，这里是德国柏林。我已经整整的离开我自己的祖国37年了，但是在离开祖国的这些年头里，我日日夜夜的怀念自己的祖国，眷恋着故乡的亲朋好友们。下面我学唱了一首歌《我和我的祖国》。
分割，无论我走
见。
Thank you. Thank you very much for the wonderful performance. 非常感谢刘克清老师的这个精彩演出啊，真是专业水准，太鼓舞人心了啊。这个小时的节目呢，我们就播送到这里。现在呢，请大家继续收听或者观看下一个小时的节目。我们想就是再播一些就是以前我们演出的一些节目啊，希望大家能够喜欢啊。如果能够继续播出来的话啊。So we are going to broadcast some more programs which we performed in the previous years, some wonderful program which I hope you still like it, and please stay tuned.